Now, we're only a few days away from ringing the new year, but not everyone has a positive outlook for 2024.
One outspoken US economist is predicting the biggest market crash in our lifetime. Yay. So what could that mean for your wallet? Well, Harry Dent joins us now live from Puerto Rico in the United States. Harry, morning to you. That's quite a frightening prediction you've made. Walk us through what you expect will happen.
Okay. First of all, for more part, I've been the most bullish forecaster. Of course, I've been coming to Australia for decades. But every great boom has an end. And this last run since 2009 has been 100% from artificial stimulus, especially coming out of the United States and Europe. So that's what makes this more dangerous. So I do think that we're peaking around here in stocks. Real estate as well. Australia is going to do far better than this, by the way. I see you're down. All I'm looking at is to go back to the 2009 lows in stocks and the 2012 lows in housing. For the U.S., that means like almost 50% in housing. That's the worst ever. In stocks, it means 86% on the S&P 500, 92% down on the NASDAQ. But Australia's stock market has not bubbled as much since then. So I'm looking at maybe back down to about 3,500 on the ASX 200, about a 50% crash, which is going to look very, very good compared to the rest of the world. My biggest concern, and I've been warning Australians about this for years, you do have one of the biggest real estate bubbles, second only to China. And so I would be most concerned about real estate. And I would look at my real estate of them in Australia and say, look, if I go back to like 2012, about 10 years ago, what was my house or office building or whatever I have worth? And that's probably the best sign of how much you could lose. And unfortunately, I think it's going to be more than most people think.
Oh, that's a bit depressing.
It is a little bit depressing. Now, Harry,
you can't be bullish for 30 years and not give a down forecast now and then.
That's true. Now, Harry, we've got to say that few people are sharing the same concerns. Why is it that you believe this is coming?
Well, simply, this has been a bubble era since 1995. And again, bubbles are not typical. The last bubble era was the early 1900s, and it peaked in the infamous 1929 top and 89% stock crash in the large cap Dow Jones back then, 25% unemployment. This will not be that bad just because the economy is more modern and has a lot more backstops from the government and stuff. But this bubble, we have had two real estate bubbles now, especially in the United States, and two stock bubbles. And both of these in real estate and stocks are worse. They're both peaking at the same time. So this is all I'm telling investors. We've had the best markets. Nobody's seen markets this good. I've studied them back to when stocks started in the late 1700s, okay? Nobody's seen long-term bull markets as good as this in real estate or stocks. But all you have to do is protect yourself for the next year or two, because we started to get this crash in 2022. That was the first wave down. But then again, with all this stimulus, we try to run up and make new highs in stocks. I think that's kind of over and we're heading down again. I think the real danger years are primarily 2024 and probably into 2025. And then, you know, we have the next boom led by Asia. And in the developed world, by Australia. The United States, I don't think we'll ever see real estate or stocks at these levels again. Australia will see much better comeback from this because you're on the Pacific Rim and you have much better demographic trends, which is my specialty, because of your not only high quantity, but high quality of immigration from Asia.
Well, we are high quality people here in Australia, that's for sure. Harry, thank you so much for your time.